And we're back, YouTube. Thank you for tuning in. As always, I appreciate that. Today, I'm going to review The Darkness 2, an occult first-person shooter from 2012. And it was actually a sequel to a 2006 game called The Darkness. And again, you play as Jackie, once errand boy for the Mafia, but now the boss himself. But then his operation is hit by a mysterious new group, a new rival gang called the Brotherhood, with an amazing antagonist, by the way. Really well done bad guy. You don't see that a lot in games.
I want the darkness!
I don't know what you're talking about.
Of course you don't. But the fact is, you're careless. And far too many criminals in this city believe you have a demon living inside you.
And Jackie has to reconnect with his inner darkness and kick some butt. The character of Jackie is way better fleshed out than in the first game, where he was mostly silent. This time around, Jackie struggles with the darkness inside, and the darkness keeps tricking him. He sort of doubts what's real and what's not. And the comic book aesthetic holds up quite well even to this day, except maybe for the lip syncing, but the voice acting is superb.
I let it out, Johnny. Now I don't know if I can control it.
You let the darkness back out? Jesus Christ, Jackie, that thing is like a slow suicide.
Then help me get it back under control.
You don't control the darkness, Jackie. You cower in fucking fear of it, and you pray it goes away. The longer the darkness is active, the more it'll try to confuse you. It'll try to trap you, make you see stuff that other people can't see.
It really looks great, and it really sort of captures that style, that style that you also see in Dishonored and some other games, but it's just so well done, and it really stands the test of time. Again, it's a unique first-person shooter with gunplay mixed with melee combat using this snake-like creature called the Darkness. You are very overpowered with that creature because it can hack and slash through enemies like a knife through butter, but being exposed to light will blind you and you will lose the creature. And enemies will use light against you, and this is an interesting twist to the first-person genre, I think. So you have to avoid light sources, or you have to destroy them as much as you can. You shoot enemies with a selection of firearms, and you use the creature to, as I said, hack and slash your way through hordes of generic-looking enemies. The action is high-octane and brutal, with lots of dismemberments. I mean, nothing beats picking up an enemy's, ripping them apart even after the 100th time, or picking up random stuff and just throw it at the enemies. Movement and controls are tight, way better than the clunky controls in the first game. Where the first game offered some open-ended and optional side quests, The Darkness 2 is way more linear, so don't expect elaborate level design. This is probably the weakest part of the game, the level design. In the first game, the creature was used to go through smaller spaces because Jackie just couldn't do that, and that resulted in some really nice puzzles. Here in The Darkness 2, on a few occasions, you get to control this spawn creature that helps you out on your quest for revenge. The snake-like creature that is always with you can be upgraded with some really cool powers, like create like this vortex hole that sucks up all the enemies in the vicinity, or you can summon a swarm of bees that will attack so that they get distracted and you can attack them quite easily. So I guess the developers opted for a more linear, streamlined experience. In doing so, it did lose a bit of the charm of the first game, but it still stands as a very unique first-person shooter, and the darkness, the creature is just so much fun to play around with, and there's really nothing like this on the market, and I'm pretty sad that since 2012 we haven't seen a third game coming out. You just don't see these type of games anymore, and that's kind of unfortunate. So yeah, really fun, brutal first-person shooter. Maybe the ending was a bit silly, but you know, 5 or 6 hours of first-person shooting never gets old, really. It doesn't outstay its welcome. Fun game. You should really play this if you haven't. Thank you guys for watching. see you next time.